I shot this panorama in the Lake District about 10 years ago. Whilst I like the scene, I've tended to ignore it because I've never been happy with the colour. So the other day I decided to try colour grading to give it a different feel using LUTs in Affinity Photo. I'll start by adding a new LUT adjustment layer to the image. You can do this in the layer menu under the new adjustment layer option, or by clicking the adjustment layer icon at the bottom of the Layer Studio panel. You can see this adds the new LUT layer at the top of the layer stack. LUTs are used a lot in the movie industry to produce a different atmosphere in films, and they work great for colour grading still photography. The next step is to load the LUT that we want to apply to the image by clicking the Load LUT button. This opens a dialog where you can navigate and choose the LUT that you want to use. The only problem you might find is that you can't see the effect of the LUT until it's loaded. I've already tested a few LUTs with this image and picked one that I want to use from the LUT pack I purchased on the Affinity store. I'll put the information for this in the YouTube video description in case you're interested. Whilst these are typically used for colour grading portrait photography, I also like them for landscape and street scenes. I've already downloaded the pack to my hard drive, which are the files that you can see. The one I want to use with this image is called Lucia. Then when I click open, it applies the LUT to my image. Now I like the effect, but I want it to be more intense. One way I can do this is by duplicating the LUT layer. I just need to right click on the layer in the Layer Studio panel. Or I can use the keyboard shortcut Command and J on a Mac, which is Control and J on a Windows PC. It's also possible to change the LUT in the second layer, which creates a different effect. I'll just switch it to use the Lucia version 2 LUT. We can then adjust the opacity of the two layers to refine the effect they produce. Now if you find that you hit on a good combination that you might want to use in the future, Affinity Photo allows you to export it as a new LUT. All you need to do is click the File menu and choose the Export LUT option. This opens a dialog where you can name the new LUT, select the format, and choose the quality. When you click on the Export button, it opens a dialog where you can navigate to the folder that you want to save the LUT to. I'll delete the second layer now because there's another option that I want to share for intensifying the effect. When I select the LUT in the Layer Studio panel, I can change its blend mode. You can select any of these for different effects, but I like to use the contrast enhancing modes like soft light and overlay. I like the effect this has produced in the center of the image, but the foreground rocks are now too dark. One way to deal with this is to reduce the opacity of the LUT layer. Whilst that looks better, I don't like how it affects the centre of the image. Another alternative if you're using Affinity Photo 2 is to add a Hue Range Mask. To do this, select the LUT layer in the Layer Studio panel. Then click on the Layer menu and choose the new Live Mask layer and then the Hue Range. I can then click and drag the selection range around to the reds and oranges on the colour wheel. As I do this, you can see the effect has become more intense in the hillside and less on the foreground rocks. What's happening is that the Hue Range Mask is limiting the colours affected by the LUT. But this does give me another problem, which is the sky. Notice that it's created a hard cutoff or transition where the sky turns blue. The way that I'll fix this is by adding a layer mask to the layer. To do this, I click the icon at the bottom of the Layer Studio panel, which adds the new mask. I can then drag it using my mouse and drop it onto the LUT layer. Now I'll select my brush tool and set it to use black with a soft edge. I can then paint out the sky to hide the effect of the LUT. I'll also paint on the mask around the foreground rocks, but using a lower opacity. This is to reduce the strength of the LUT there, as I don't like the rocks when they're too dark. What you might not realise though is that the Hue Range Mask still works with the area of the image where the LUT is visible. Now earlier I set the blend mode of the layer to overlay, saying that the contrast blend modes work well. To better understand the overlay mode and get some more ideas on how to use it, watch this video next. Thanks for watching today and I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe and please share it with others. I'll see you soon for another video.